Tonight we're having a very special Where's Waldo edition of The Late Late Show. I came out to say hello to the ladies and gentlemen, the studio audience, and three of the members. Look, three of them. And they weren't together, were they, boy? They were separate in separate areas, weren't they? You saw them too, didn't you? Go and check them out. I'll be right over. I hate that horse. It's nothing, it was a joke.
Hi.
All right. Ready? When I tap you on the shoulder, please state your name and where you're from.
Jean Gertz, Thornton, Illinois.
Janet Meyer-Dirk, Yuma, Arizona.
Chuck Harms, Salisbury, Maryland.
Right, Chuck. Ladies, if you'd excuse us for a minute, would you? You understand why I brought you up to the front, don't you, Chuck?
Yeah.
You're wearing the same shirt as a couple of ladies.
Maybe you'll talk to us, too.
I'm not doing this to shame you, man. It's for your own good, all right? Ladies, including Chuck, I have a question for you, and if you can answer it correctly. Are you here with anyone?
Oh, yeah, my friend, Merrick. Oh,
your friend?
Merrick.
Oh, hi, Merrick. You said it like I know him. Like, Merrick, come on, man. Sorry, Merrick, of course. Yeah. How you doing, man? What's up? All right, so, are you here with anyone?
Yes.
Who are you here with?
My husband.
Uh-huh. Right, gentleman over there, and...
Jean's here with her daughter.
You're Jean.
Yeah, you're Jean. Jamie.
But you said Jean's here.
Jean's here with Jamie, my daughter.
Well, Craig's asking you why you're saying Jean.
Say that again.
Anyway.
I'm here to see you.
Yeah, well, good news, because we're going to send all six of you out together to a restaurant.
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Which restaurant will you send them to, Michael?
Cafe La Boheme.
Cafe La Boheme, the expensive one.
But I have three.
Wow. You have three? Three people?
Daughter and husband.
Your daughter and your... Oh, that's fine. Yeah. No, Craig says that's fine. What do you care, man? We're out here in December. We can just give it away. All right. So, here's the question. Chuck, this is one for you.
Okay.
All right. Or ladies, there's a large music festival held in Palm Springs once every year. What's it called, Chuck?
I don't know.
Oh, come on, man. I tailored that. It's exactly for you.
Yeah, I don't know.
Come here.
You know what it is?
It's Coachella, all right? Coachella.
She knows.
Anybody got any ideas?
Yes.
Coachella is the right answer! Where's Waldo? Late Late Show.
Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Listerine Whitening Plus Restoring Rinse, a healthy way to whiten. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
feel completely blown away by your... Is that what the warm-up comedian said tonight?
Blow him away. Yeah.
I'm like, don't you come out here and blow me away. Yeah. You know, it's... well, good evening.
Yes, yes.
That was exciting.
That was very...
I just thought, when you see the audience this excited and so pumped, I think, they're going to be so disappointed.
It's sad, really. It's sad.
Yes, I know. But it is, however, a great day for America, everybody. A great day for America's first family, Kim and Kanye.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Is it Kim and Kanye or Kan and Kimmy? Whatever. Whatever. I'd like to say congratulations to you both on your wedding. Unless this is a rerun, of course, in which case my condolences on your divorce. For a moment there, it looked like I wasn't going to be a TV jackass. No, just for a minute. And then I was. Anyway, they got married in Florence. Now, their name Florence holds special meaning for Kim because it's the name that Bruce Jenner goes by. Nah. Oh, but it's only a joke. Man, they really liked me and they've turned on me already.
You got oohed early in the game.
Yeah, I know. Anyway, it's also a great day, a really great day for San Francisco. Someone in San Francisco is hiding $100 bills in strange places across the city. Right now, men all over San Francisco are searching every nook and cranny for the booty. They're also looking for the money. I had to do that.
Yeah, you had to.
It's just that's the rules of TV jackasses. That's right. What we do.
Right.
Congratulations also to the remarkable Jessie White. This is true. Jessie is a woman from Maine who just graduated college, and she's 99 years old! Yeah. I said, she's 99, so a little bit louder, I think, please. Everybody. Yeah. It's a great story. She was asked what she was going to wear to her first job interview, and she said, depends. So... I know.
Yeah.
Look, I know. I'm a jackass.
Yeah, right, right.
I'm not proud of what I just said. I don't... I feel terrible.
You had to do it. You had to do it.
I have to do it. It's my job.
Yeah.
It's my duty as a late-night TV douche.
That's right.
Dude, there's a new reality show on Fox tonight. It's called I Wanna Marry Harry. This is true. And it tricks women into thinking they're in competition to marry Prince Harry. Is that even legal? Can you do that? I don't know if that... You can't trick someone into marrying you. Well, no, actually, maybe you can. Happened to me.
What the hell?
No, not the current one. Everything's great there.
Right.
I'm talking about back in the day.
Yeah.
For legal reasons and... No, look, everything's fine. Goodness gracious, it's just a joke, everybody. What's going on?
The hell, man?
You know, you make one joke about Bruce Jenner and suddenly they turn on you. Anyway, I think impersonating a member of the royal family should be against the law. Otherwise, you might get something like this. Look. I'm not proud of what I did. Apparently, the Queen is horrified by this I Wanna Marry Harry show. She's like, why would my grandson marry off someone on a TV show when he could have... This is the Queen talking. This is what I'm doing. Why would my grandson marry, you know, someone from a TV show? He could have the pick of any of his first cousins. Wow! See, you are so judgmental this evening. They've already announced a spin-off show, I Want to Marry Camilla.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
We might as well get the get it out the way then, won't we?
Go ahead, man.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Do we have a picture from that show? Yeah. You knew it was going to happen. Now, look, don't come to me. Now, you see? There you are.
Yeah.
Finally. Finally, someone that gets it's just a joke. Well, that's enough TV monologues
for
me.
Yeah, man. That's comedy gold, boss.
Comedy gold. Many of the jokes in there aren't really jokes.
No, they're not. No.
My tie swinging around.
Ooh, I like that, yeah. Your little swingy tie. I like
my
that.
Tie swinging. The yeah. tie, of course, represents...
yeah. No, we got it. We got it.
Do you know what I did today?
Oh, tell me.
I got my annual physical today.
Oh, yeah?
Man, I swear that doctor enjoys that. Yeah.
I'm acting surprised. I was in the room.
Well, you were the doctor. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Where's Waldo? Where's Waldo edition of the show? Oh, yeah. Isn't that amazing? They all arrived separately, but now they're together. That's the power. Jeff, what is that the power of?
It's the power of late night television.
That's the power we have to heal and bring people together. Because I believe that children are the future, right, Jeff?
Yes, yes.
Is it hot outside?
Oh, man, it is really hot.
How hot is it?
It is so hot.
Take that, other shows that yeah. finish your jokes.
Yeah.
We don't have time to finish your jokes. We're helping people here, helping them.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like Dr. Phil, except I'm... Oh, no, I'm not a doctor either,
no,
so
not.
I'm just
no,
like valid. Dr. Phil.
That's valid, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Maybe daytime TV is where we should go next.
Oh, that's the move, man. That's the move.
I don't know. You'd creep people out.
Oh, I hear
oh, you say, oh, now, but when you see him in daylight, you'd freak out. What time is it, Jeffrey Peterson?
It's Tweet Mail time. Time to take advice from America's favorite late-night TV jackass, Craig Ferguson.
Play the jingle, would you?
Euro trashes and Euro litter. Head on the dance floor and shake your Twitter. Bum, 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 bum. Check the tweets.
Plus, emails.
And your emails. All right, Jeff, this is from Joe in West Middlesex in somewhere in America.
Yeah.
Have you ever been to Middlesex?
Middlesex, yes, I have.
And what did you like about... ah. What did you like about Middlesex?
It's hard to get out of the bed.
Yeah. dear... yeah. Dear Craig and Jeff, I'm thinking of taking my wife on a cruise for our 30th anniversary next year. Any suggestions? Yeah. A boat.
Yeah, yeah, get yourself some oars.
You oars, know. Yeah.
Sure, sure.
Or maybe just a car up and down Sunset Boulevard.
That's
I don't
idea.
Know.
Yeah, hell yeah. Put a boat on top of the car.
That sounded expensive,
yeah.
Jeff. Anyway, I hope that's been of help, because that's what we do here. We help people. We're not interested in jokes. We help people, right, Jeff?
We're going a new direction now. That's what
we're going
doing.
A new direction. We're talking higher. That's right. And with weird, smiley cult faces on. Right, Jeff?
Yeah, I can talk, but I don't have lips.
Soon, when I get my injections, I won't have lips either. Going to look like this all the time. Ah, for heaven's sake. Oh! What a surprise!
Hello? Craig, it's Don Rickles. How are you?
Don Rickles?
I'm very upset. I'm very upset. What are you doing? What's wrong with you, you hockey puck? What is this show? What is this crap you're doing on the air?
Are you sure this is Don Rickles?
I was informed about, you know, 20 minutes before the show started that I had to call in as Don Rickles. So this is the best that you're going to get.
You know, it's very convincing,
you know,
Don Rickles.
I don't, yeah.
I don't know who the one of your best ones yet, Mr. Rickles.
I don't know who the dummy is. You or that skeleton. I can't tell which one's the dummy. You know what I'm talking about? This is Don Rickles again. I'm reminding you, this is Don Rickles.
What do you want, Don Rickles, if that is who you are?
I'm just calling to see where I could get some Middlesex.
Yes? Anything else?
Just want you to come into bed and lay on one side. That's all. That's all I'm saying. Like a sandwich.
Don Rickles there, everybody.
Don Rickles.
I can't believe that was Don Rickles.
That was Don Rickles. Different.
I think he called in because his special is on Spike TV tomorrow night. And rather than come on the show and actually promote it, he had a stand-in. Hello?
My special is on Spike TV tomorrow night.
Thanks, you're Don Rickles.
I'm Don Rickles.
Yeah. All right. All right. Don Rickles there, everybody.
Yeah, Don Rickles. Yeah, just learn that voice in 5 seconds. Go ahead.
Look, nobody's going to judge anybody for trying to do Don Rickles.
You're giving that guy a hard time, that guy, that Rickles guy.
If I knew that was somebody doing an impression of Don Rickles, I'd say, good effort. Hello?
This is... forget it.
Who?
Click.
Wait. You can't say click.
No, I hung up the phone.
Hang up the phone, I can still hear you.
Don Rickles pretending to hang up the phone. Click.
We're right back, My first guest tonight is an American treasure. Her show, Hot in Cleveland, is on Wednesdays on TV Land. Take a look at this. Yes, it's Betty White, everybody! I think they're happy to see you, Betty, as I am myself.
Well, I've been noticing the last few times I've been on the show, we got kind of silly. So tonight I'm going to be very dignified and I'm going to be a little more serious. Are you?
Yeah, come on. Yeah. Are you all right there? Is this chair too high?
No, I like it.
Hold on, I keep on
No, I can't
here.
Swing
Hold
my
on.
Legs if it's any lower.
No,
I like this.
Oh, you do?
Oh, I do. I like to swing my legs. Didn't I ever tell you that?
Well, I'd heard a couple of cab drivers tell some stories, but I... Hey, how are things over at Horton Cleveland? They all right?
Okay. Well, yes, and when are you coming back to see us?
I don't know. Soon, I hope.
Will you please?
Yeah.
I
love it over
everybody
there.
Everybody loved having you there.
Well, I like being there, being had by all you girls.
But you know, the funny thing is, we knew you're wonderful at whatever it is you do here. But we didn't know you were such a good actor.
Oh, please.
Oh, please.
I had to play someone who had a murky past and a Scottish accent. Oh.
which you got a stunt check.
Yeah. Hey, how are things? Didn't you go to Cleveland recently? You actually went there?
I actually went.
What were you doing?
You went to Cleveland, and I went to Columbus just this last
Columbus, week. Ohio?
Yeah.
That's the Paris of the lower Ohio Valley.
Well, but it's Jack Hanna.
Oh, Jack Hanna, the animal man, yes.
And so we're great and good friends, so I went to the zoo and he took me all through backstage and I was holding koala bears and I was holding cheetah babies and I had the most wonderful time.
Well, you know, Betty, I'm worried about you holding the cheetah babies, though. Cheetahs are, you know, that's quite an aggressive animal there. That could scratch you.
Oh, no, that's all right. Jack went for my throat, but...
Yeah, well... Well, that's only because you were swinging your legs around.
Hey!
Yeah, is that... Have you ever, I always wanted to ask you, have you ever been with an animal and you thought, oh, this is a hot, because you love animals so much.
Anything,
right.
Anything.
But have you ever spent any time with an animal and thought, I don't care for this animal at all, I don't like it. Like, for example, a cat.
Oh, a cat?
Oh, yeah, for example, an animal that you didn't like, for example, a cat.
Oh, how dare you even put it that way.
Very understanding. I mean, you're telling me you've never been attacked at all by an animal once? Even pecked by a bird or something?
One time I was hurt. The only time I've ever been hurt was by a swan, of all
things.
They're
vicious. No, they're vicious.
No, I was driving through the country. Alan was doing a summer stock show, and I was driving out to see
it. It got in the car?
So what?
The swan, did it get in the car?
No. So there was this beautiful river and a beautiful swan. So I stopped the car. I was all by myself, about in the middle of the country. And I stopped the car and got out and to walk down to the river to see this swan. Well, I didn't know he was married, because there was all of a sudden out of left field over here, I must have walked by a nest, this swan came out and hit me with the upper part of his wing. It was like being hit with a baseball bat. He hit me right.
They can really hurt you with their, yeah.
He could have broken my leg. In fact, I thought it was broken.
And then did he just leave you alone after that, or did he continue to peck?
Oh, no, that's all he was just telling me to get away from his nest, which I didn't know was there. So he was
maybe a respectful, ah!
But it was, and it was so silly, and when I got back to Alan and stuff, and I was limping and all that, what happened, honey? I got hit by a swan. It's so ridiculous.
Well, you know, I've been in dangerous situations with swans before.
Oh, really?
Yeah. There used to be a canal near where I grew up, and swans would nest there, and we would go fishing, and they would come by and peck.
Yeah, but they don't do it this much. It's usually with the wing, you know, this wing. No.
Yeah.
That's another swan.
Yeah. All right. Why don't we just keep it all contained? Well, apparently we're out of time, Betty.
I know we're out of time. I love the way they call ahead, you know, when you're going to do the show, and they ask you all kinds of questions, then we'll talk about this and we'll talk about that. We never talk about any of it.
Well, to be fair, Betty, we've known each other longer than the producers on the show have known you, so, you know, I don't need them to say, Betty's coming, you better talk about this.
No, you don't need any of that.
Are you saying the opposite of what's true?
I promised I was going to be dignified tonight. I really did.
Well, you can start.
Oh.
we really are out of time. Do you want some chocolate or something?
No, I'm going to get out of your hair now, because I can't swing my legs anymore, and I can't make any jokes, so I'm going home.
I feel your pain, Betty. I feel your pain.
Betty White, everybody, we were over.
guest is on CNN's international business correspondent and presenter of Quest Means Business. That's how you have to say it. Say it, Jeff.
Quest Means Business.
Quest Means Business. It airs weekdays on CNN International. Richard Quest, everybody. Richard Quest. To see you. I see by your shirt and tie you mean business.
I mean business.
Are you very good at business?
I'm dreadful. If I could make money doing anything else, do you really think I'd be doing this?
Yes. I feel your pain. Are you you're from somewhere else? I recognize your accent.
Yes.
Swiss?
No, I come from a couple of dozen miles south from you. From Yorkshire.
Yorkshire!
E-bag-gum! Give us an E-bag-gum!
Yorkshire! In the north of England.
I was born in Liverpool.
Liverpool, where the Beatles are from.
Do you know, if I had a dollar for every time you say Liverpool and somebody says that's where the Beatles are from, I'd be a rich man. Yay!
I don't mind if you never mind. I was going to make a sack joke. Anyway, look,
I'll just rearrange myself.
Right, I like your watch.
Hands off.
It's got two watch. Is that because you're international?
It is, because I'm very international. The top one is always where I am.
Right.
The bottom one is always somewhere else.
And are we still talking about the watch, or are we...
I gave you that one.
Yeah, I saw that.
Quiet
over
there. Yeah. Were you talking about Middlesex?
So, have you become a citizen then? Have you moved to these United States and become one of us? One of us.
No. Not yet.
I
have the necessary papers to ensure that I'm here legally.
Oh, no, I wasn't questioning your legality. It wasn't like, may I see your papers, please, Richard? No, that's not my job. I just wondered. I'm an immigrant myself. I became a citizen. I'm American now. It's very nice. Oh, very comfortable.
Yeah. So since I'm a business correspondent, that means you'll be filing US taxes for the rest of your life wherever you live.
Yeah, I don't mind.
Worldwide taxation.
I don't mind at all. I don't mind at all. It's worth every penny. Please don't audit me.
Or me.
Yeah, yeah. So do you go back to Britain a lot then?
Yes, I go back about once or twice a month.
Once or a month?
Yeah.
You must be on airplanes all the time.
I am. I pretty much live on them. So I was in London on Saturday. I'm here today. I'm in New York tomorrow. Back to London and then to the Middle East.
Do you enjoy flying?
Oh, I love. Come on. It's absolutely amazing. Here you are. You have this machine. This fantastic machine that takes several hundred people, scrunches them together as close as you possibly can get, shoves you into the air, feeds you bad food.
You're turning me on a little bit.
Yeah. But I have a question for you.
Yes.
It's one of life's great conundrums when you talk about flying.
Right.
What do people do in aircraft toilets that takes so long?
Number twos?
No, you see, I don't think they do it. Well, put it this way. Not those new flushing toilets with go whoosh.
No. I've got this medical condition. I can only go twos at home.
You and I.
Yes.
Are the same age. And, listening to you talking earlier. We are.
Yeah.
Listening to you two talk earlier and seeing Betty, who's just fantastic.
Oh, unbelievable.
I mean, if I am that sharp at 60, I'll be pleased.
Yes.
But we are 50.
I'm actually 52.
I'm 52 too.
Oh, right.
So we're two to 52.
We are the same age.
Two 52s. It is a miserable age.
I don't mind it at all.
No, come on. You're lying.
No, not really. I mean, I'm in a good mood because I went to the doctor today.
Yeah.
But
That's what happens when you get to 52.
What?
Bits start hurting, and you start to think, is this the start of the decline? My shoulder's been giving me jip. Right?
Well.
Bit painful. And now you start to think, what's next? Is it all downhill from here?
You're freaking me out, man! I was feeling fine. Do you worry about that a lot?
Oh, I do.
Really? No, you mustn't. You gotta live in the day, man. Live in the day. Don't be living in the future or living in the past. It's right here, right now. That's all there is, man. That's all there is. That's all there is.
So you are enjoying being 52.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. I don't mind it.
It's a miserable age, but you've got a certain level of success. You're starting to think, what's next? You're wondering if it's all over. Is it all over?
Not till December.
But what's after that?
Well, I can't say right now for legal reasons, but I think it'll be all right. Do you worry about that all the time?
Oof.
This would be hell. You've got to get some... Like, let's get you some therapy, quickly. So, you are frightened of death,
Terrified.
We are the same age. Why so frightened of that? It's, you know, it's an inevitability. It's one of these... It's nature. It's a circle of life. Hakuna Matata. It's okay, man. It's cool. Everything's cool. That's all there is. Do you feel better? That'll be $150. You can't walk around like that. You torture yourself. What about in business? Do you think like that in business? You're giving people business advice?
I'm not giving advice. I keep telling you, if I could give people advice...
Yes?
...and make money, I wouldn't be doing the job that I do. But I learned at a very early age that I couldn't sell water in the desert. I'm a terrible businessman. Shocking.
I don't know if I... So... You're doing very well, though. You've got your own show on CNN. That's on. You're on your way.
Well, I hear this chair's coming vacant.
Yeah, you can have this one.
Thank you.
It's not mine to give away, but you can have it. Yeah, you'd be fine at this. Would you do a late-night show?
Oh, I'd love it. I'd love it.
It's not all gay skeletons and fake horses, you know. There's other things involved. Actually, it's easy. It's very easy. Yeah, you'd like it. You could do one in Britain, couldn't you? You're there nearly half the time.
Well, it's never really been as successful in the UK, the whole format, as it has been over here.
I wonder why that is.
There's not a lot of humour over there, in that sense.
Oh, they're very funny over there.
Not late at night. They're too pissed.
They do after about 10 o'clock at night. Oh. Nah. Do you know what I've noticed about British...
Particularly where you're from.
True. I've noticed that British television presenters, if you notice this, they all have the same cadence in their voice. They all say, they start talking like this, and they end the sentence like this.
I didn't do that, did I? And so it was clearly going to be a day when things were going to happen.
I think that that's true. As I asked my colleague, the Not a Real Horse.
And when the Not the Real Horse decided it was going to run away... It disappeared with the skeleton in the cupboard.
Perhaps you would like it if I said it like Don Rickles.
Richard Glass, everybody! Are a terrific band. They have been on tour all summer. They were here last week and I asked to come back again because they're so...
Ay, caramba!
Good! You can't use that word on daytime TV.
No, you can't.
They're here performing Golden Age. Please welcome back Jamestown Revival, everybody!
Good times are over, didn't you know? Well, I heard it on the radio. I read in the paper and I saw in the news. through. My, oh my, where did Cassidy go? The wild ones all grew old. Times they are changing. Yesterday's dead and gone. So play me that old time music. Play that familiar song. I'm just a holy roller with a gun in his hand. Changing. Yesterday's dead and gone. So play me that old time music. Play that familiar song. Play that familiar song.
That was awesome, man. Thanks a lot. You can be great. Jamestown, we gotta go.